Thank you. Now, Dr. P. Balachandra.
Good afternoon. I think after so many presentations and so many experts, what I feel is the titles might look different. You know, the concepts, the thinking might get repeated. You know, I have tweaked the title a bit. Basically, you know, all of us are aware of energy technologies and energy sources. I think what is important is, you know, given the, you know, significant energy inaccess situation in India, the purpose is to make that energy available, make that energy work, and make that energy deliver benefits for the people, those who need it. The benefits could be perceived or tangible. You know, sometimes the previous speaker said, television is more important than food, or mobile may be more important than cookstoves. You know, anything is possible, but the benefits are necessary. Given this, the idea is motivated through this. I think this we are clear about, you know, presence of large section of income poor, they are vulnerable, they are deprived of all those benefits, you know, we consider as common and readily available. The second idea is, you know, access to local renewable resources, you know, both hard and soft biomass, which is available in plenty, solar, unlimited, and we have near commercial sustainable energy technologies. And rural India is, you know, has those entrepreneurial qualities. You know, 50% of our micro and small enterprises are rural based. As someone said, you know, may not be from the rural people, there may be outsiders coming and setting up enterprises. But still there is a use in terms of local value addition, you know, creation of employment, entrepreneurship. The idea is, can provision of energy bring several benefits that leads to empowerment and resilience? And the underlying idea is, energy plus is equal to basic energy services, which cannot be avoided, plus productive energy services. And the emphasis needs to be both on energy value chain and productive use value chain. See, given the problems of scale up, the solutions are not going to be simple. The process would be quite challenging. Unlike, you know, we give the technology and it works fine and poor derive benefits. I don't think that assumption is correct. I think the challenge is big. Though I have reversed the graph, India is number one in both the cases. The challenge is really big. And as I said, giving energy is not a sufficient solution. Empowerment needs to be the ultimate outcome. Empowerment could be in terms of income, in terms of knowledge, in terms of entertainment, livelihoods, and other opportunities. And how we can do this? This Energy Plus approach is conceptualized by UNDP, but I have contributed both directly and indirectly in terms of evolving this concept. That's why I am considering it as my own contribution. And outcomes expected of this approach are four-pronged, you know, livelihoods and employment, enterprise opportunities, education and health access, enhanced agricultural productivity. The question is, can energy provide all these things? Again, the underlying question is, it may be an inadequate solution, you know, picking up a problem and trying to solve that. I feel, you know, it should be package of solutions solving majority of the problems. And our ultimate dream could be, you know, rather than solving a single problem in the rural context, can we transform a traditional village into smart and sustainable village, where, you know, there will not be any need for urban migration or creation of urban slums. You know, that is the kind of idea. And what they need, you know, what we call as energy plus access needs. You know, because of the limited time, I will just read these things. What we call as basic energy services. Again, one more point I want to highlight here. people don't require technologies. And I don't think we can expect them to work on the technology and produce energy for deriving energy services. I think they also want to behave like urban, what we call as consumers. In the press of a button, light is delivered. Over a phone, you can get your gas delivered. Why it should be different for the rural poor? So the focus is on services, basic energy services, then the lifestyle energy services, you know, cooling, TV, heating, mobile charging, then we call as social energy services, education, health, then productive energy services, you know, which basically gives them entrepreneurship, employment, and income generation. And livelihood services, basically what they are currently doing, can we make them to do it in a better way with energy as an intervention? I think several enterprises one can think of using this as a concept. You know, energy provision itself can be visualized as an enterprise. Then once you have energy, what all one can do? I think that is what is listed here. Anyway, I will, you know, basically this slide says, you know, what energy access can do within a village ecosystem. Could be related to agriculture, education, industrial, you know, in terms of small and micro or rural health centers. You know, we can visualize energy as a driver for delivering all kinds of developmental benefits. And as I said, the process is not so simple. We need to focus on, you know, developing that energy value chain and the productive value chain. That means the interventions need to be both energy related as well as non-energy related. And that gives us what we call as energy plus. You know, this is a kind of a concept. You know, the process starts from what we call as baseline needs assessment. You know, what they require and what is available. You know, when you say local resources being used for local empowerment, you know, starts from baseline understanding what kind of technologies and what kind of energy delivery mechanism. It should be socially driven system or an enterprise driven system. The kind of enabling policies, institutional support, you know, community mobilization, a good revenue model for sustainability. I think profit may be a bad word, but that cannot be excluded when you want to have a scale up and a running model. And finally, capacity development in terms of skills. I think the process looks complicated, and it is no different from running a large corporate. And the productive value chain looks something like this. You know, access to end-use technology, you know, how to use that energy that is available. You know, access to finance could be microfinance, access to knowledge, capacity development. At the end of the day, access to markets. You know, the cycle needs to be complete in terms of, you know, the whole ecosystem. And also it is important to have several indicators of measuring those outcomes and outputs. Those needs to be quantifiable and verifiable. I think that needs to be used as a lesson for the next step. You know, how do we go about scale up? I think rather than focusing on one village, can I take that benefit to thousands of villages? I think that is the approach we need to follow. I think I will conclude that enterprise objectives are changing. I think they are becoming triple bottom line. I think the interventions need not be only profit oriented. Other aspects can be included. And sustainable development cannot be achieved ignoring 3 billion people in the world. I think this is the final message. Thank you.